Let us continue the discussion, and this part that we're going to discuss about is how do we get light into a fiber optics cable? How do we get light? How do we inject light so that it gets propagated? I want you to understand the science behind this. And so, how do we get light into a fiber optics cable? How do we get light inside so it gets to travel? Yeah, if we remember correctly, I said previously, in our previous discussion, that when we talk about fiber optics communication, mainly we are talking about core of the fiber, which is the central part, which where light travels, and we talk about cladding. Cladding is basically the outer part that actually enables light to get confined into the core. And we discussed something. We said, let's assume that the core must have a higher refractive index than cladding. So let's say that our core here is 1.5, because it should have a refractive index that is higher. Let's say our cladding is slightly lesser, so 1.48, and here also is cladding 1.48. And we know that we have to inject light at a certain angle to achieve total internal reflection, because we discussed about total internal reflection, and we know that it is through total internal reflection. Without total internal reflection, light cannot be confined into the fiber optics cable. So let's assume this is our light path, and it is now bouncing back and forth into the fiber. And let's assume also that here we have kind of a boundary. Let's assume this here. That after this point, let's assume our cable is cut and the core and cladding are actually now exposed, that at the end you can see like the tip or the end of the fiber. It means in one way or another, this ray of light that is propagating is now going to get out of the fiber. So because there is some kind of bending, let's say it is now going to escape and get outside the fiber. Because we know here we have air. Here we have glass. And here we have glass. Both these are glasses. But all these glasses are of different refractive indices. The point I want to bring to you is, it is important that the core should have a higher refractive index than cladding. But also, it is important, what other thing that is important to achieve total internal reflection is the angle at which light is allowed to get into the core of the fiber optics cable. If this is messed up with, if the angle is messed up with, we won't be able to achieve total internal reflection. And how do we achieve that? Of course, we discussed it previously about critical angle. And we said to get critical angle in our previous formula, our critical angle should be equals to sine inverse of N2 divided by N1. N2 refractive index of cladding, and one refractive index of core. So if we want to assume that we are talking about this kind of a system, our critical angle here will be how much? It will be sine inverse of N2, which is 1.48, over N1, which is 1.5. And if we calculate this, if I'm not mistaken, our critical angle will be something around 80.6. It will give something around 80.6. 80.6. 80.6. That means our light has to be injected through the fiber, because we're talking about 80.6, and we know when we talk about 80.6, that is the angle from the normal. So if we can assume that we are talking about here, this is where we are talking about, then it comes, that is this angle from normal, theta critical. Even though we know it's slightly different from this, because that enables us to achieve total internal reflection. It doesn't enable us to achieve total internal reflection. It enables us to achieve critical angle is the angle of incidence for which the angle of refraction is 90 degrees. Our ray will be going parallel to the surface. So, if this is the case, and this is also theta critical, even though we know it's not exactly critical, because critical travels at the surface, but here it's already bouncing. So it should be at an angle that is a little bit greater than this critical angle for us to be able to achieve total internal reflection. So even if you consider this, it means here we'll have 9.4. The angle here is 9.4. Let's talk about that. That is 9.4. If this angle is 9.4, and let's say maybe we are considering now, because we know here we have glass, and here we have air. Can we get this angle? Surely we can. Can we get this theta? We can call it theta 3. Angle with which light emerges from the fiber, using just the normal assumption that we have taken. This can be obtained. How can we get that? We know N1 sine theta 1 equals to N2 sine theta 2. N1, we are talking about glass and is actually within the core. So 1.5 sine theta 1 sine theta 1. Our sine theta 1, our theta 1 here is 9.4. Because now the normal we are talking about is this normal here. We are considering from glass to air. So our normal now is this one, is no longer this one. So with that, this will be sine 9.4 degrees is equal to N2 is air. Refractive index of air is 1 sine theta 2. What is theta 2? We don't know it. That is what we are looking for. It is here, it is theta 3. So if you calculate this, you'll get actually our theta 3 will be equals to something around 14.18 degrees. So this angle here is 14.18 degrees. Of course, we know this thing is a bit magnified, but we know it can't be exactly 14.18 simply because with 14.18 here we get actually the angle of refraction, which is 90 degrees, which is not the case. So we're just considering a hypothetical case to try to explain something to you here. As you see, if we can manage to have light to travel through the fiber, bouncing back and forth, and that gets out to the air, the same path that it takes, if it is reversed, if we shine light through the core of the fiber at the same angle, like theta 3, light will be able to travel through the fiber. So this example here actually just indicates to us that apart from refractive indices, differences within different medias, the issue of angle at which we shine light is critical to be able to obtain or achieve total internal reflection. Now I want us to go forward and look at some simple formulas which actually enables us to understand better and even get well and easily the angle that we can use or through which we can shine light to the fiber optics cable to achieve total internal reflection, so that light is confined.